5 years ago, GSK and Save the Children got together with this amazing mission to use GSK know-how, science, and leverage Save the Children presence and credibility to ensure that no child should die from a preventable disease, protecting 1 million lives.
One of the reasons that I wanted to join Save the Children was the partnership with GSK, which brings together the best of the NGO sector with the best of business, the unique skills that we both bring to it.
It really fitted into the ethos of the company to make a medicine that could have such a major impact on reducing neonatal deaths. We visited several villages in mud huts where mothers were applying chlorhexidine.
Chlorhexidine is a critical part of child survival. I feel like we're finally moving in a direction where we can say babies can survive.
Universal health coverage is really important, and the sure way to make an impact on reducing the number of children that are dying from preventable diseases is to ensure access to healthcare services, staff with the right equipment and the right skills in the right place at the right time.
We've been able to draw on the expertise of GSK to ensure the supply chains in some of the world's poorest countries to deliver the treatments that are saving lives and improving health across the world.
Seeing life, you know, the impact of what we do is incredible.
I'm very privileged to be here today in Kenya, Bungoma County, and be able to see the impact of this partnership. And I had the opportunity to meet Baby McLean, which was the first baby who was supported by this partnership. He's now not a baby anymore, he's now 4 years old. Like Baby McLean, thousands of other babies and mothers received GSK and Save the Children support. So I'm very excited about the next phase. I think we can do even more to help people.
Working together, we've achieved absolutely extraordinary things over the past few years. We should celebrate this partnership because it has made a huge difference to the lives of some of the world's poorest and most marginalized people.